Lianli's SX series includes three models with maximum power ratings of 850, 1000 and 1200 Watt. These units come in two colors, black and white, to match your chassis. The 850 Watt is already certified by Cybernetics as platinum in efficiency, with the certifications of the other two members of the family to be announced soon. What is interesting to the majority of users is the pricing scheme Lianli used for members of this line. The street prices are competitive given the product specifications. $120 for the 850 Watt unit, $150 for the 1000 Watt model, and just $10 more for the flagship model with 1200 Watt maximum power. Given the slight price difference between the 1000 Watt and 1200 Watt models, the latter will be the preferred choice for most users. Another note is that the black and white versions have the same price tags. The front of the box features a photo of the PSU along with two badges highlighting ATX version 3.1 and PCI CEM 5.1 compliance. The capacity description is in the bottom left corner. Around the back, you will get the product highlights in several languages. Inside the box, everything is neatly arranged with the PSU securely protected by packing foam. The PSU's exterior design is interesting since it makes it stand out from the crowd. According to Lianli, the specific fan grip provides better airflow thanks to its open mesh design. For sure, it boosts looks. At the front, Lianli calls it the rear of the unit, but it's actually the front, is a smaller switch to enable or disable the fan's passive operation. The modular panel has 12 sockets, including a native 12-volt 2x6 header. The PSU comes with a large number of connectors installed on long cables. Besides the single 12-volt 2x6 connector cable, there are also four 6+2-pin PCI Express connectors distributed across three cables. This means that even if you encounter a graphics card that requires three of these connectors, you can use dedicated cables to power it, which is the ideal scenario. The main cables use braided sleeving, including cable combs, while the SATA and 12-volt 2x6 to dual PCI Express 6+2-pin cable use flat ribbon sleeving. Zhongyuan Power supplies this platform using an APFC, a half-bridge topology, and an LLC resonant converter on the primary side, which controls the primary switching FETs. The MOSFETs are not from a known manufacturer, for example, Infineon, to keep costs down. This doesn't mean, of course, that they won't do their job without issues, at least under normal operating conditions. On the other hand, all capacitors on both the primary and secondary sides are sourced from reputable brands and are part of higher-end series. The small PCB is loaded with parts, yet it still provides good airflow to the filtering capacitors on its secondary side. The heat sinks are tiny, especially on the primary side, which saves space but makes cooling sensitive parts more difficult. Increased efficiency is the key here, keeping operating temperatures low without increasing the cooling fan's load. To check my detailed part analysis, read the full review please on hwbusters.com, link in the video's description. Load regulation is tight on all rails. Ripple suppression is decent at 12 volt, but it could be better on the minor rails. The transient response with normal loads is good on all rails, especially at 12 volt. In the ATX version 3.1 transient response test with loads up to 200% of the PSU's maximum power, the 12 volt rail performs pretty well. The holdup time is long and the power K signal is accurate. The power K inactive to DC loss delay period could be shorter though. The in-rush currents are at the expected levels given the NTC thermistor's resistance at normal operating conditions. The PSU supports alternative low power modes. The platform offers high efficiency at normal loads, but not at light loads. At super light loads, 2% of maximum capacity, it gets better, achieving clearly over 70% efficiency. The average efficiency meets the Cybernetics Platinum criteria. The APFC converter performs well enough at 115 volt, but there is room for improvement at 230 volt. The 5SB rails efficiency is high. Vampire power is low at 115 volt, but above 0.1 watt at 230 volt. The 12 volt OCP triggering points are appropriately set, since the hot point is set lower than the one at normal operating temperatures. Moreover, the respective thresholds are not too high. On the other hand, the 5-volt rail's OCP triggering point is not set correctly since the HAT threshold is higher than the normal one. The difference is very low also at 3.3 volt, almost non-existent. I would like to see a large difference between the normal and HAT OPP triggering points for more effective protection. All other protection features are present and operate as intended. My only criticism is the absence of fan failure protection, which should be a standard feature on a high-end platform. The PSU's EMI emissions are under control, but only if you use an extra attenuation, so the EMI receiver is not overloaded. This is something that I need to explain in a future video. The PSU's average noise output is low enough. The fan's passive mode is affected by the load on the minor rails when the load at 12 volt exceeds 125 watt. In general, the fan's noise remains low below 500 watt, with a 25 decibels level reached at 550 watt at 12 volt. With more than 690 watt, the fan's noise is within the 30 to 35 decibel range. Given the platform's compact PCB and the lack of large heat sinks, the fan speed profile is tuned to balance quiet operation without jeopardizing long-term reliability. At 230 volt, the fan speed profile is similar to that at 115 volt. The overall performance is competitive, especially if you take into account the decent price tag. Want to get a Windows 11 or Microsoft Office license and you don't want to pay a premium? Go to KissFan and select what suits your needs better. Pay and get your key in a matter of minutes. Besides Microsoft products, you will also find a large variety of other software at KissFan, including download, system, editing, antivirus, and security tools. There is also a selection of software for Mac OS. For any kind of software you need, take a look at KissFan first. Why pay more when you can get what you need for way less? Lian Li is trying hard in the PSU market, working with new manufacturers to achieve high performance to price ratios, which are what most users are after. In this product, the SX0850P, the overall performance is high thanks to the tight load regulation, good transient response, increased hold-up time, and high average efficiency. On top of that, the PSU offers quiet operation at loads up to 550 watt. The only downsides include the relatively low average efficiency, the 20 to 80 watt range, and the increased pile power on 230 volt. On top of that, ripple suppression on the minor rails could be lower, and the same goes for power factor readings at 230 volt, which should be higher. The only reason I do not provide a recommendation badge for this product is that the protection features, and more specifically the OCP triggering points on the minor rails, are not correctly configured. If this were the case, the SX0850P would easily get a recommendation award. Moreover, it would be ideal if a fan failure protection feature was present. This is not as easy as it sounds on platforms that offer a semi-passive mode, but in my expert opinion, such a mode is unnecessary. On the contrary, it would be highly preferable to use PWM control fans spinning at low speeds under light loads to minimize bearing noise and keep operating temperatures under control. Somewhere here, I have to end this video, but please keep in mind that before investing in a new power supply, read my article on the best ATX version 3.1 PSUs to compare all alternative PSU offerings on hwbusters.com. That's all. Bye-bye.